me, miss? Not by a long shot. Well, you said that we would still be friends, but I'll admit that I was glad it was over. I love a good chase.
Welcome to Summoner's Rift.
Yeah, I'm just telling him to start Ice Ball. If you start Blood Boil in the lane, you have no trading pressure. Because Blood Boil doesn't really help Nunu much at all. It only helps the AD carry. Whereas Ice Ball does damage and it prevents their AD carry from doing damage. It's better for early pressure. Like, let's say we did a Nunu Caitlyn lane, and I took Traps and he took Blood Boil. They could just run at us and we cannot trade with them. So, like, it's better... It's honestly better if I just take Peacemaker. It helps me do the golems faster, and it's better for trading. So, like, if they happen to force a trade on us, and we have Ice Ball and Peacemaker, we can trade back with them. But if we have, like, supporty skills, then it's a lot harder to. Alright. You should let me tank this. Tank. Look at this, I'm not even taking damage. See that? That's why I like these runes. Just tell them to let me tank it. And I'm like full HP. Doesn't even matter. And then when we start pushing, which you should always do on blue side, unless you feel like you can't deal with the ganks, generally you want to hit level 2 before them. So you want to start pushing a little bit, and it also gives you creep advantage so they don't want to trade with you, and it just gives you a huge advantage. As long as okay, I don't know why he did that. He just threw an Ice Ball at Taric when we're level 1. Kind of a waste of mana, but I guess he's using his passive, so it's not that big of a deal. Interesting. Alright, well, I'm level 2 now. I want to put some pressure on these guys. There we go. Just keep hitting him under tower. Because Taric isn't doing anything for Draven. This Draven has to fend for himself. I'm kind of feeling bad for him. But it's hard to play a melee support on blue side when you're losing like this. Because if you go up for presence, you just get poked. Like, that's what I'm doing to him. He threw one axe at me, it's not a big deal. I'll eventually heal it up. So you notice I'm not even taking traps, I'm taking things that'll help me trade. Don't be caught flat. Okay. Draven can't follow up because he's too far back. So Taric just took a lot of free damage. I shouldn't be missing any of this CS. The idea of doing this is that I pressure him under the tower, and he loses CS from being pressured, and I get all the CS by pushing. Another random stun by Taric. So he's gonna trade hit for hit with me, and I'm just going to heal it up with my life sequence. Whereas he went longsword 2 pot, so he doesn't have that sustain. Just gonna poke him out. And Draven can't follow it up. This is just really hard to deal with. Blue side Caitlyn. And we took our golems, that's the big thing. We hit level 2, they couldn't pressure us. So now I'm gonna start putting traps down. If they hit that, they eat a Peacemaker. And he's low HP, he doesn't wanna fuck with us. Okay, I made sure not to attack him. Well, that baited me, sort of. I kinda really didn't want to. That was not worth it. I don't know why. Yeah, he just went in and started tanking, so if I didn't flash in and kill him, he would have just died for free. It's not a good idea. Oh well. So, right now I'm, oh wow. Oh god. He's all dead. He's dead. Can't save him. Oh my god, what a beast! What a beast. It's fucking Fiddlesticks. God mode. Good job. So yeah. I mean, it was kind of a small mistake because we sort of threw the lane a bit. We had a huge pressure, like, building up in the lane. He had to base. He was going to lose a lot, but instead we evened it out because we went 1-for-1 under their tower. I wasn't able to just keep the pressure up or, like, get all the CS. I missed a lot. He missed a lot too, but he would have done that regardless of if we killed him or not. So he had to go back. Okay, so we both chunked each other. He finally got a Vamp Scepter, so our sustain is going to be pretty similar now. Okay. So when your support goes back to heal, you kind of have to let yourself get zoned a bit. I can't go for that CS. It's too dangerous. Okay, random stun by Taric. I'm going to walk up and get the EXP at least. This kind of sucks, but it's what happens. If your support goes back, then you just gotta sit back and wait for him. Oh, that was awful. Okay, my, we don't have any wards, but my net came out at a bad time. I wanted to queue the creeps and then net away. I probably should have done the net and the queue, like the EQ combo, so I could go away first, but I was greedy for the CS and they hit me. Ugh, sucks. We're losing this lane now, off of that stupid thing that just happened. We're losing. That's how important it is. Like, someone makes a small mistake, or you guys make a small mistake, you just throw your lane. We're losing now. We were owning them so hard, like, you guys saw it for the first 5 minutes of the game. He was under his tower the entire time, he couldn't do anything. Now he's actually pushing into us, and we're losing. Which is like, that's, I don't know. I shouldn't have done what I did. Like, I should have just let him die. If he wanted to do something like that, I should just let him die. But I didn't want to go 1-for-0. That would be bad too. What is he doing? Can't do that, dude. Whatever he's doing, it's bad. I don't know what he's doing. What is he doing? Yes, Nunu Kate does do well if you play it correctly. If you just randomly start fighting, you lose. Caitlyn's not a carry that fights people. She pokes, she outranges them, and you push them. You don't just start brawling with them and at an even fight. Like, now that we have creeps, we can fight them. We just poke them like this. You don't want to just run at them and snowball them and lose all your HP. I'm trying to, like, tell them what to do, but seems to keep Blood Boil on me. Blood Boil's pretty huge for Caitlyn. She doesn't have any attack speed steroids. This guy's dead now. Nice. That's all we have to do. Yeah, I don't think so, dude. Go, dude, stop! You have slain an enemy. God, I had to flash there.
An ally has been slain. An enemy has been slain. Let's investigate.
Alright, and we're back. I'm gonna get my BF sword. Oh, that was decent. And we're winning. We're back to winning. So that's just how you get control of the lane against like someone like Draven on purple side.
Wanna see a hat trick?
We don't want to fight them in an even fight. We will lose those. We want to push him in. We want creep advantage. And we kite him. If he runs the trade with us, we poke him, walk away, net him, Q him, and let the creeps beat on him. And then when he's afraid to fight, we run into him and we just orb walk him down. Stuff like that. And we just force him into bad spots. And that Nunu ulti was really good. The one he did right here in the bush, where it split up Taric and Draven, and we were able to just kill Taric. And then Draven couldn't help because he was all the way sectioned off back here by the ulti. So it was a really good ulti by him. And we were able to just pick up a Taric kill, and then Draven got greedy to stay in the lane. He didn't want to leave, and so we just towered over him. I thought it was a little risky. Like, even though we saw them on the map, I didn't know how that would play out, but it ended up working out. I just had to use my flash, though. I was tanking the tower. Nunu couldn't tank it. He was too low. That's why I didn't want to do it. But it ended up working out. Okay, got Taric's ulti out. Oh, he ice balled the wrong guy. Oh, shit. Okay. Well, to ice ball Draven, not Taric. Or I die. I don't like that. I didn't like that. There it was.
Your team has destroyed a turret.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
I just want, what I want this guy to do is I want him to stop snowballing Taric and running into melee randomly. I want him to stop doing that. Maybe I have to type it out, so I'll type it out. Okay, after I'm done CSing.
Don't be caught flat-footed.
That's all we gotta do. I don't fight and die, you die. I don't think he understands what I'm saying here. Is if I leave him to not get owned by Draven, he will die. I don't want him to. Guys on his own. Well, okay, good ulti. Well, that was pretty rough.
Time for a shakedown.
Just gonna heal back up.
I have the tools for the game.
This guy's got nothing left. He's got a BT already. I almost have an eye edge, so it's not too bad. What the heck? Oh, there's the KO ulti. Oh, I got one. Felt like I could have killed more there, but oh well. Let's see if I can take this tower. Probably do one more wave. Yeah, I can do one more wave. They're really low. Got this. Got this, guys. I felt like if I flashed sooner, I could have just killed more. Probably should have just flashed into the bush immediately. Oh well. Nice job. And I'm gonna get my Zeal too. I'm pretty damn strong right now.
Enemy double kill.
Yeah, I didn't want to E in because I wouldn't have enough mana for the ulti if I did that. Let's see. CS wise, I'm winning. I'm just gonna do these. Oh. What happened? Oh god. Oh god. Run, run, run. Oh shit. Bad Draven ulti. My bad. He saved me. I was doing something risky.
Me? Miss? Not by a long shot.
Fiddlesticks got this, dude. Oh shit. All beast plays, fucking beast plays right here. This guy, the fucking god fiddlesticks. Oh my god, oh my god, dude, they're gonna 2v4 them. If I stayed around, I could have sniped one, but I didn't think that would happen. Holy shit, dude, this fiddle is a beast. That's pretty awesome. Is he tanking? Yeah, I guess he's kind of tanky. They just like peaced out. They're like, oh shit, it's Fiddle. And they just like let him do whatever. Just walked into their team 1v4. He's like, sup, dudes. Push, push, push. Let's go. Push it up. What's up, bitch? Where are you going? Oh, God. No! GG, son. Nice try. He tried to block it.
Want to see a hat trick?
I can get my PD. I could probably get a Last Whisper, actually. They have a lot of them. Oh, shit. Well, he was forced to flash. Oh, nice. He's in.
That's
pretty good. Nice team. That's how we do it. Let's keep pushing. Kayle's coming, but her ulti should be down. Alright, I'm gonna piece it out. I'm out. I'm out, sons. Let's see. I want the PD or I want the Last Whisper. How much armor do they have? I think I'm gonna get the PD. They're not building too much armor right now. And I'm almost got the Last Whisper. Let's get that.
See a hat trick?
Then afterwards, I can make my BT. That's right, guys. The main thing that you're noticing here, I'm not building the shitty Blade of the Rune King item. Please don't build that item as a first item on someone like Caitlyn or Draven. The only person I would ever like consider that item on first is like Vayne or something. Maybe Cog. But like, I see people build it way too much. And then they just don't do any damage afterwards until, like, unless they're dueling. But, like, team fights, it's not that high of damage output. Especially with someone like Nunu on your team that gives you attack speed. Yeah, I just don't like it. Especially when people build, like, PD afterwards, and it's just, like... Yeah, I don't know. I really don't like it. Like, Caitlyn's not there. There's no possible way they could be doing anything. Oh, they know. They fucking know. Alright, well.
Dominating. Killing. Double kill.
Well, they stole it, but they got double ace, kill. So worth it.
Ace.
All good.
I have the tools for the job.
Oh, they surrendered. GG. I don't know. I felt like we could have done a lot better that game.